Bryophytes generally for sexual reproduction water is the necessary. Water is necessary. Male gametes are released from antheridia. So these male gametes are known as antherozoids. So these antherozoids are biflagellate. So they are swimming in the water and reach to that egg cell. Reach to egg cell. So this type of fertilization is known as zygogamous type of oogamy. After fertilization, so then zygote is formed. So egg cell is present in that archegonia, only single egg cell. Archegonia having that only single egg cell. Okay. So that is known as zygote time of oogamy. Zygote is formed. After zygote, so immediately is not that embryo. Then zygote is converted into that embryo. Embryo is differentiated to that multicellular diploid structure that is known as that sporophyte. Right? So this sporophyte producing spore mother cells. These spore mother cells undergoes meiotic division producing haploid spores. Most of that all bryophytes are produce similar type of spores. So that is known as that homosporous condition. Homosporous means similar type of spores. Similar type of spores are formed. That is known as that homosporous condition. Okay. Then this homosporous, spores again they are germinate to producing of that gametophyte. Gametophyte, okay. So that is that introduction to complete that. So general characters of that bryophytes. After that, economical importance of that bryophytes. Economical importance of bryophytes. Bryophytes. Generally, bryophytes are very little economical importance. It is that very little economic importance. Okay, but mosses, well-developing bryophyte plants are known as the mosses. Mosses provide food for herbaceous mammals. For herbaceous mammals, birds, and some animals, right? In this mostly, so it is known as sphagnum. It is also known as the peat moss. Why it is known as the peat moss? So it producing smooth blackish substance that is known as the peat. Okay, peat used as that fuel. It is used as fuel for long time, and it is also transship. It is at a water holding hydrocolloidal substance. It is also hydrocolloidal substance. Hydrocolloidal means water holding substance. Water holding substance. Due to the presence of water holding capacity, then it is used transshipment of living material. So transshipment of living material. Okay, transshipment of living material means meat or that for example it is act as that just like that soil to that living plants, transport from one place to that another place. So that is known as transshipment of living material, right? So after then, bryophytes are used as in some, for example, in some bryophytes they are ecological importance process. So in that ecological importance process, so it means mosses along with lichens, involve in rockening of soil. It means, so when that mosses along with lichens are present in the on the bare rock, so after some times this bare rock is break down. Bare rock is break down, convert into soil. So this soil is suitable for growing of other plants. It is made suitable to growing of other plants.